welcome all. We'll get started in about 2 minutes. Yeah. Welcome all. Thank you so much for this registration. So I think we should really get started so that we can have a number of meditative sessions. So this has been the kind of a course that I've been doing for the last 3 years. Largely for engineers and for IT personnel, but curriculum is
is this? I can make it a bit bigger.
And in a CV, always please mention, the V. What matters always is what you credit as V. V says here, maybe in a group of, five or six people, maybe you might have done a project. While talking about the particular project in a meeting, don't mention I, always state as V. Okay. That is the most inherent, aspect, when you get into the CSC. I is more the person, B is the kind of a team. Okay. And always you mention, how you prepare the pitch for that. There could be some kind of a challenge in the project that you might not have been able to do. You could probably write that. You can always try to bring the expertise, how all those six people in a team might have got your expertise, and what was your exact engineering expertise that you had for the particular project in the system areas. And always talk about engineering strength in the form of going to do things. And what is that kind of a difference that you might have learned as opposed to Always talk in your always in a CV, please don't mention experience. Always talk about achievements. Always talk about achievements, not experience. Maybe you might have done a work for an organization of 5 years. 5 years is not a PhD in the world. 5 years is not enough. What matters is your achievements. During those 5 years, how many productive works you might have done? That's very important. You can always tell me mention saying the various songs of the case studies, if there is a live active URL or a website for that project, or all these kind of things. And then I can go on to the honest and the mission. Of course, please always add a search page and a kind of a, main thing profile, which are absolutely very, very, very important. Please do not mention Instagram and Facebook. Those are not your focus sites. And always know SWOT it. SWOT it in the sense that we talk about the world in SWOT. SWOT is strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, and frontiers. This is my typical SWOT in the sense. Silence knowledge is very important. And my biggest critical.
I'm so critical that my mind is in the middle. I'm going to tell you this second video of life, which is still a kind of distress for me. Very many people misunderstand me. So whenever someone needs me, short is distress. It seems to make it less. That is a step on what you are.
And this is what you can also be one liner in your CV.
But in your CV, you can show that you are always
And should always ensure that you are also engaging with something. It should not be no paragraphs, it should not be no, like, you know, like a big
spacing
words,
but
it should be
this. And in your CV,
many people
would
write
very
clearly
stated
statements,
but it's not a very great way. So do not write very clearly stated statements as you see them.
It's not any kind of a document that you're writing, you know, saying that those statements are true to the best of my knowledge, all these things not go through it. Please do not insert any lengthy abstracts, instead give it a short URL.
And
please start with lower chronological order. Start with the first things that you are recently graduated, that's great, and then your previous this thing, and then your previous undergraduate schooling or high school or whatever.
Please
do not mention weird hobbies.
Watching
TV, watching cartoon, all these are probably not some kind of hobbies that you might want.
You might
want to say that
you
like kayaking,
you know,
all those kind of things that play very important role.
And
always
know,
if you are a scientist, if you are a researcher,
which in many cases you are
all, always try to ask
what
you are
not sure.
What's
the
score
in a class of, say, X,
in terms of the percentile, in terms of the
CGCG,
or whatever.
So
maybe that plays
a
very important role, the percentile of this
case.
And
it's
always
mention
negative
results.
We always
know publishing
reviews.
In fact,
I don't know publishing
reviews.
Many people
think
that
they
don't know
negative
reviews.
It's not
publishing
reviews.
Negative reviews are
publishing reviews.
I've had
not
quickly
received
60
seconds
for the
back
matches.
So
I always
learned
that
I don't
know publishing
negative
reviews
from
mathematics.
Just
to make sure that everything
is
okay.
I'm always
audible.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Please mention that you need a paragraph.
In the first line, you will give some presentations. Thank you so much.
Whereas,
cover letters
always start with yes, yes, yes. Yes, take, take me off, this is something different from another level, or you know, right, 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 but you should probably start your first few sentences saying, saying that, that, no? What's the reason they could be thinking of, what could be, in second level. And not entirely, or not entirely, because at a time where they are, and most importantly, you should always sell yourself by making it more exhilarating. What involves you think your purpose to pick the job? That's the most important thing of the selling story when you are expecting your purpose. And it should also have, you know, what impact has on that. Please, don't make any easy words that you know that in instance when you are the best critic and the best scientist in the world, the best research man, all those things are not available. Please don't. And final sentence, always know, and the note on high, always say that thank you very much for looking into my education. What were your biggest assets in the form of spot, strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats? Most importantly, any point of time, you can look at failures and successes. Always be incisive, don't blow the things, don't cover gas. Be incisive and always talk about you know, you really don't have cross prospects for this and you are getting looking for this good job. In the second paragraph, you can always talk about, you know, current job matching with the profile. And then, you know, quickly move towards your past experience as well. So, for example, you might have even taken up a resident as best potential caliber, where you might have come up with a similar experience of the matching with the profile. And then, you know, you can come up with, And as I told you, the third paragraph always ends on it, I know. And cover letter should also have an essay in data of the cover letter. Your sincerely mention all about family as well. And what is right when you are existing. So after you are sincerely, then you say who? Say Dr. So-and-so, so-and-so, and with businesses. And I think I told you about this, don'ts and don'ts for cover letter as well. But references, connected references, always write the address with the email and number in this email. And mention why you can contact it. Avoid uploading the reference letter unless asked. This is very, very important. And if you have any transcripts, always keep those transcripts very important. And reference making is also very, very important. Which references your friends make first? Which reference may you are considering first in your place? Very important. So, for example, from my experience, virtual people, I get a lot of, you know, requests from my meetings. They ask me to give references. I've never seen them. In fact, when I met them, I make them virtual. Someone directly says that, you know, I really want to, probably, you know, given a kind of a reference. It's not really a kind of a good idea. You know, say that I can really say that, first reference should always be your first mentor at school, in the future, and then your project seeker, and then comes your dean, and then fourth one will be anyone outside your position in that school. Maybe your good relative as well, distant relative, and I can help you overcome some kind of fear mongering syndrome, or imposter syndrome, or something like that. That can also be taken. And then, as I told you, this is what the first reference is your career mentor. That is the most important thing. Your college teachers, mentors, and friends, and sometimes friends can also make a good stance of learning your friends. The third one is, of course, your college advisors. That way, you can always take that as well. That way, you can also take a semester and learn. And please understand that these are all wonderful scientists. There are at least 5 Nobel laureates here. And of course, they're all scientists, wonderful scientists. But they were also unsuccessful. They never got any opportunities. Ever first, and some of them, even at the 18th time, even at the 19th or 20th or even 21st time, also, some of them, they never got any opportunities. This is a bit, unfortunate thing, but they always know converted these negativities to positives. They always know taken these negativities to positives, and they could sell their known unsuccessful stories and successful stories. So then you might want to ask a question of the kind of scientists. Of course, these days, many people know. Not that interested in doing it in a PhD.
Come
come next generation sequencing, I converted myself towards system genomics. I call myself as system genomics. There's nothing wrong where you keep on changing your adjectives and calling yourself as a scientist way of practicing medicine. 5 years, you might be a realization of Bangalore, maybe you can do one more good at system genomics, you might do that. Just transcriptomics, something like that. Those kind of things are always very, very wonderful things on the whole. So for that, you need to get your thoughts. Always ask in some kind of problem orientation issues. Always know species, consistency, continuity, and variability. Say, for example, you keep on reading some kind of book every day. That makes you consistent. But you need to ensure that it is familiar to your sojourn, your journey. That will give you bring out some kind of variability in you. That will make you kind of a vociferous reader. You don't say that I'm reading once a week or once a month, but then make you vociferous. So that is a very important thing. And of course, patience and perseverance is a very important thing. Always know. Ask what I don't know. I only know what that's a very bad thing. Okay.
What
I ought to know, what I should know.
Okay. Have some an
inkling of
curiosity.
Okay. And sharing experiences.
I know
many people are good fans of these mobile phones.
Okay.
You might be having some extra packs.
Almost
upload this app in your brain as well.
Okay.
Aspect.
Have
some kind of
quiet,
coming up.
And then first bite,
have some spitting from that particular first situation that I try to take up for some aspiration.
And then that will be the most
important thing, don't end up over there.
Please
pass on
the pattern
and
what
you have done
there.
I'm absolutely kind of a very open minded
scientist.
I don't say,
I should probably ask
several questions
only
within
one
group, but also
the
teacher. It's nothing asking open questions.
If you have an idea,
I'm sure
that
you only can
get
a
group
ready. If I say that if I discuss an idea in an open forum, I will close.
Okay?
It doesn't mean that
you
know my idea is
understood.
In fact, you have two weeks every time. Even if people,
tries
to take that particular
idea,
they will not be able to tell
you
for the first
question.
You
are
the
legend
child behind
that.
And then sometimes you have to make an innovative sometimes
the
job.
The very
first question
you
ask is,
discover
yourself.
Then if someone asks you,
discover yourself in 15 seconds,
you
have to say your story.
You
say to that,
yes, I know.
This scientist, PhD in systems genomics from Marburg University in Denmark.
I've had a couple of years of experience
before joining the
Reliance
Space Science
Research
on American
Columbia.
Then I moved back to
America,
down south to
Amerika
University
and
Guidelines
University,
but
then
there
is
my
mind.
And this is where,
I
can
sell
myself
and
the kind of things
that
are allowing me to
keep
the
back
and all this,
kind
of things
on
this.
And
this is how you can describe about yourself,
the
postcardial conditions, the visits, and all this kind of things. Something like that. So this was
my
spot. This is how I describe my spot.
I moved from
gratifying things to
I described a typical cover letter,
but you're also welcome to send me a sample cover letter, where you outline.
just to make it understand and like that.
So I would appreciate if you can like on this. We have like those people on the service, yes, service members and groups. And we have produced 7 main things across 30 countries, you know, and that is a separate thing as well. And if at all you can land up in a flaw, okay, don't decide.
This is my wonderful quote from Thomas Edison. He says, "I have got a lot of lessons, which, you know, somehow they have been wrong." So these are, you know, some of the very, very important things. I thought I'd tell you some important things. I think it's kept us right on stand now about many people. Any quick answers from this? Anyone? Who have not seen this, can you have the answer to this? Can I move the microphone? So this what has been taken with the gender balance? We see not only men, they are not even conspicuous of the fact that there is a man, you know, behind the gun. And she's taking a huge, you know, over here by this. It's very unfortunate that, you know, there's a big disparity here. You know, gender balance is not well here. We still call it, you know, the men from behind us. So start respecting the men. And we see some of them, a lot of times, and some stats, a lot of these people are going to crack up, you know, generation 6, generation 1. That's probably going to have a particular environment in that. This was going to be a big data challenge on the universe as well. And this is December 2022. And I always take to know that March 2020, you know, March 2nd, the precise as the World War II Day. And the director, you know, comes to the land, says, you know, the land is for sub-1 country. And then
Pans, you know, get paid, you know, we spend a lot of time.
I discuss sometimes my own papers, I discuss with my
stupid suggestions. But some of those suggestions comes with their reflections. They help me a lot.
We need to be good
leaders, good listeners.
So
this is
what
I call it as
an
arts principle.
Ask,
meet,
collaborate,
and heat.
And
keep smiling,
always
keep hopes,
take
tomorrow in your bags.
Always
consider COVID as a
kind
of blessing in disguise.
Okay?
Not
as,
as a kind of a big,
goals
we have today.
And
next year,
we
are going to have a significant conference
session,
which we are going to announce very soon.
So we
are going to organize in this again.
It's
kind of
scary,
expecting one of the major
projects
as
well,
which
I will tell
you. But
welcome
to Join BioFis organization,
which is
India's largest
plant-medic
society,
with
5,000 active members.
3,000
of them are automatically mentored, and
they're
in place across 30 different countries.
We
have got several BioFis interest groups.
We
have
a
women in biology program.
We have
published over 65
papers
in impact factors 2
and
28.
We have
several
virtual
projects.
We
have
violence
rights for student children as well.
We have
children
in
Paraguay.
And
we have Facebook,
LinkedIn,
and
service
access apps as well.
I'll come
to this particular
slide
later
after
the
things
are there.
But I'll
probably just
stop
here.
If
you have any quick
questions,
I'm very happy to answer. So that I'll
start
giving you the
gist
of how to type
and
the kind of a book,
cover
letter.
Any
questions, please?
We
have about
30
minutes, so this
could,
please, Jayashree, quick.
Sir, I was always looking at that if I can write something like this, like in my weakness, can I write something like I just stick to the problem solving. Sometime I spend a whole night to solve a particular problem. So is this the good thing to write in a weaknesses?
Yeah, that's absolutely a great
point,
Jayashree.
You
should always be putting
in
a defense type,
You should
say that,
sometimes
I wake up all night,
finish
the
job,
but then I realize that,
I should have
done this job,
and
I might drop this
time
and maybe next time.
Which
means
you're
again
in
the reverse,
revibrating
it back.
But
again,
you're
converting
your
cross
into
your strengths.
There's
nothing
wrong.
You can always
mention
that.
Okay, sir.
Good evening, sir. This is Swapnil Mishra. I'm an undergrad at BHU Zoology Honors, and I've been really having trouble about my research internship in the summers of the topic which I what I should choose and how should I come up to it.
Wonderful, Swapnil. I mean,
always
go by your interests, okay? And that is number one.
Second
thing is always
chose
a mentor who can afford to give you time.
That
is very, very important. Please don't
Wi-Fi,
don't
buy
Wi-Fi in space, CCNB,
medium
Wi-Fi,
So always
go by your
interests.
Always have
implicit
in this.
Maybe
your mentor might be a
business
listener
after
looking at your
challenge.
So a good mentor
always
appreciates your
ideation.
Maybe if someone sends me a mail saying that I want to have some things that I have to.
I
always ask my
question,
how I could
really
fit in the thing.
All
the
time I
want to know,
if I can
find
a place to
any
of my collaborators
or
any of
my mentors. There
are
many
mentors,
many good mentors
who
can help
you,
understand
your
kind of
mentor.
Always
give
that kind of
mentor.
So
there
are
always
no
mentors.
I hope
that
helps. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yeah,
and
someone
always
makes
a
question.
Hello, sir.
Yeah,
sir, this is Swati.
Yeah.
Sir, I have a question. While we are applying for postdoctoral, in that cover letter, can we mention, I would like to enhance my particular skill, I'm a bioinformatician. So can I mention like that I'm looking for such kind of opportunity and I would like to.
Hello sir.
Yeah, yes,
yeah. So I'm working as a bioinformatician in next generation sequencing software development firm. So my question is, as we are working as an employee, every time we don't get the type of work that we want, like the core bioinformatics, sometimes we get the work that is not so much related to the domain, but it is critical for the development of such an next generation sequencing complex software. So at such a moment, I find it very difficult to continue my interest with the core bioinformatics, to work with it. Sometimes I feel like I should quit my job and go for more academic field, like doing a master's in bioinformatics or doing something like that. So this is my last problem for me from recent some months, how to cope up with this and manage both of them. Thank you, sir. Yeah, yeah, thank you. Hello, sir.
Sir,
during my master's thesis, I was working on evolutionary genomics, so I handled genomics data only and just data. But for my PhD, I wanted to apply for some PhD which are project related to regulatory genomics, gene expression, and single cell genomics. But I don't know whether this experience which I got during my master's is
this will be relevant for that position or like?
Google form. Yeah, I wanted to know. Currently, I'm working on some research. Like it's like a project, small project, but it's not it's unpublished yet. So I wanted to know if it's all right if I can include that in my college application. Okay, thank you.
So,
Yes.
Thank you.
Covering letter, I forgot to mention. This is your SOP. Covering letter.
poet mention after this, right? Dr. Roberts, something like that. This you can also write it here. That's the difference between a cover letter and an essay. Okay. And regarding the CV, I'll show you my CV. Usually in a CV, you know how it should be, you can say don't start with doctor, okay, get a PhD, not a doctor, no longer than that, and always say, it has a suffix, become a PhD, okay. You can write career story or career summary. Career story is more precise, okay. Career story involves all this kind of things, like this article, okay. Then your academic record, okay. Always start with the latest, say, for example, here, what is it I've achieved, okay, and currently what projects or whatever, and then the previous project, what is that I've achieved again, okay, mention that, and previous that all my 8 or 9 years of postdoctoral years of experience, okay, that I've done in Denmark and in other places, okay, in US and other places, I mentioned it here, and again achievements, okay, and again your PhD fellow, you have done your PhD, title of your thesis, okay, and then your quick summary, what is your PhD about, and then your portfolio PhD, what is that, my MSc, okay, my BSc, okay, you see, my career record, I was a BSc in microbiology, and I had bioinformatics, MSc in biotechnology, PhD in systems biology, okay, and my test 1 and test 2, which we call it as intermediate, fellowships and grants, all my whatever successes and grants that I've achieved so far, and my other things, any scholarships, any postdoctoral fellowships and other things, skills and activities, my scientific memberships, okay, I've supervising learning and teaching experience, okay, I can specifically say what are how many PhD pieces I've supervised, any postdocs mentor, any associations with companies also you can write, okay, all these kind of things. All courses that I'm going to teach, the next course in 2023, okay, that I'm going to teach. In any recent conferences or talks, okay, all these things you know, I can mention. And then comes the personal thing, okay, my date of birth and other things, okay. If you have any biggest things and assets that are your associated, like IRS, bookmarks, and other things. My publication records and associated leadership. Finally, we will not take all those 90 or 100 publications that you have, but you can write as a publication and write some key publications. Okay? And then you can write all those publications. My thing is not more than 4 pages. I don't know why it came to thank you. It's not more than 4 pages. No one would have time to get you to your 20 or 30 pages of this. Okay? Please mention it as. Do not write impact factors. I'm not a big fan of impact factors, although sometimes I mention it. Okay. Always you can say mention, say that for example, this particular paper of us, these two papers have been cited almost 300 times. You can mention it as this has been cited 300 times. Those things always you know help you. Okay. I'll just probably stop here. Welcome to ask me any questions over email or through, preferably through email. Sorry, not through phone or this thing, but yeah, I'm listen to email. As soon as you send me an email, I quickly respond actually. If you have any questions, I'll be very happy to answer. Yeah, Jay Kishan, you had some questions, please. Yeah?
Yes, sir. My My question is just a continuation of the Somnath's question that he mentioned that he have a background of something diverse and he would like to change something in a PhD. So I have a question like if I would do same thing, then should I spend 1 or 2 years in acquiring some skills which is required to the other field, or I just go through the application process?
I think, you know, as I told you, in a CV or in a cover letter, you can always say that you don't have that expertise. But you see how nicely I crafted that letter. Okay. I don't have this entire experience or this experience, but I'm confident that I can make out. That shows your confidence. It means you're selling yourself. Okay. Your opinion, they say, would they would, you know, that yes, you know, you see how nice your education is selling yourself.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yes, sir. Sir, Satya here. How are you doing?
Yeah,
I'm doing fine, sir. It's a wonderful session and also very useful. And also, I think then you have to arrange one more session for how to write the grant proposals. Grant fund. You are expert, sir. You are expert in that. It would be useful like us, like a young early researcher, early career researcher. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
Hello, Omkar here again, sir.
Yeah,
as I mentioned, I work in the software development, but my current role is not that much interesting. But I got some offers which are totally related to data analysis, not in the development side, and that really fascinates me. But at the same time, I don't have the confidence in actually analyzing the engine's data. I have confidence in building the software itself or the managing the data of such a large system. But my question is, how should I prepare for such a placement, or how should I plan for shifting in such a company?
Yeah. Then he came again the matter of idea. Yes. concerned?
Thank you, thank you, Doc. I'm very grateful. Connecting always with you guys. I believe one day I'll be there physically.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
I'm going to go to the next one.
பின்
Data.
background literature ko likh dunga main. Self-help groups as well. And then, you know, we can